Light of Autumn.
Okay, we're gonna swap quickly to the match because they have started. So Lars Bohne play the gemstone mine and is immediately activating it, getting rid of one of the mining counters. The clock might be a little bit off because I didn't hear the judge calling, so but might be maximum a minute. Going into Ancient Stirrings, what's he looking for? I see an Amulet of Vigor in his hand already.
In his hand? That's the five card.
Oh, that's the... Okay, yeah, sorry.
He's one to take the Amulet, I guess. If
probably.
He has enough land.
He has bounce lands in hand already. I saw the Simic bounce land in hand.
What does it? I saw in Summoner's Pact in his hand.
Yes, that's the Stirrings. He took the Amulet of Vigor. There's another bounce land in there. Yeah, obviously the Vigor Amulet is the best. Odd play from Michael de Brabander with John. No turn one play. You want to disrupt normally?
Yeah, I don't know how many discards he's playing.
Let's have a look. I have his list here. He has 3 Inquisitions, 3 Thoughtseizes, and that's it.
Yeah, but still, most of the time you want to have one of the disruptive pieces.
Yeah, indeed. He also plays removal, of course, but that's not going to do a lot.
But yeah, if you have a steady hand with Jund and you don't know what you're playing against, I also would keep a steady hand.
It depends on the strength of his hand, of course.
Yeah.
He's playing 3 Dark Confidence, 3 Assassin's Trophies, Coifs. He has a lot of turn 2 plays, definitely. But is it going to be fast enough against this combo deck?
I don't know.
Yeah, he has his Amulet.
I don't know who's favored, but I think maybe with the... With an Assassin's Trophy, I think, it doesn't do much against Lars. I think maybe Lars is favorite in this matchup if he
can get off a quick combo kill.
Yeah. Like
that explains the turn 2 keep.
Yeah, confident turn 2 is good.
Very strong. Does he have a lot of interaction with things?
Especially
like
against this kind of deck because most of the time they don't play removal.
Mm-hmm.
I think Lars only has 1 Walking Ballista and an Engineered Explosive. Oh, and the Zakama in the main. And
that's going to be awesome.
I hope he's going to play it.
Yeah.
It's the 9-9 dinosaur, right?
With
the 3 colors?
Yeah, it's the 3, the red, white, green dino. I'm going to look it up if I can spell his name correctly. Zakama. Primal Calamity. For people that don't know it, that's it.
Look at the beauty. And it enters...
9-9 Vigilus, Reach, Trample. When it enters the battlefield, if you cast it, untap all lands you control, which is nice in this deck, of course, and a lot of great abilities. Removal for enchantment artifacts, small creatures, and life gain. I don't think the life gain is that important in this matchup.
No, and that's an Azusa. I guess, Lost But Seeking,
yep.
So we can play 2 additional lands.
Yeah, he has an Amulet out already, so it's absolutely fantastic to get it.
But...
How is he going to pay for his pact?
He has a... I don't know.
He still has a land drop to make, and now he has enough mana.
No.
Yeah, but...
He's
playing the Azusa immediately and can make another 2 land drops, he said.
Yeah.
So the gemstone mine comes back down.
It's going to be tapped for mana.
Let's see how he follows this up. An Ancient Stirrings again. Trying to get more of his combo done. The Ancient Stirrings, what is it really? Yeah. To Talaria West to transmute for
his... Yeah, just to get his special lands
or his
bounce lands.
Does he need a lot more? Isn't he good to go if he can find his Titan next turn?
Yeah, I don't know, but maybe he should have just taken it slow and went this turn to get his Titan. I don't know. Maybe this play is better.
That's one of the bigger hits in the Jund deck.
Yeah.
Only the Bloodbraid Elf is bigger.
Yeah, but still, you just have to take some damage.
But is it that good a card to play against this type of deck? Because he has so many extra lands he can get rid of? Or am I seeing this wrong, Reese?
It's still removal for the Azusa.
Yeah, okay.
Because it's not that great against... Why is he... I don't know. He doesn't have a land, I guess.
He's offering up the trade.
Why would he offer up the trade when he has Liliana and he revealed Liliana?
He has also another expensive card, Maelstrom Pulse, Colagan's Command. Yeah, oh, he does have a land drop.
Just get Liliana down, minus it, and...
Be done with it?
Yeah, I think that's... I don't know what he has in hand. Maybe he has a Thoughtseize in hand. Maybe do that.
But if he had that in hand, why didn't he play that on turn 1?
Oh, but wait. Doesn't he have an Assassin's Trophy? Can you just win then with the Assassin's Trophy? If you get rid of the Bounce Land?
Well, he has two other Bounce Lands.
Yeah, but he don't care because he can fetch a basic, but he has to pay for his pact and his upkeep.
Ooh.
Isn't this how that works?
Maybe he just wanted to check his hand first. But as a Maelstrom Pulse, I see. Do you really see an Assassin's Trophy?
No, I don't know for sure. I thought this wasn't...
He's flicking through them too fast.
Yeah. Maybe it's an Assassin's Trophy or maybe it's a Bloodbraid Elf, but I don't know for sure. I guess it's a Bloodbraid Elf then.
I don't think he would have missed...
Can you show the art for Assassin's Trophy, maybe?
I can. Just give me a sec. Or a few secs.
Or doesn't... Can
I don't know if it's on...
It can destroy lands, right?
Yeah. I'm not sure if it's on Gather already.
Yeah, it is.
Here we go. There is the art and the beautiful new card.
I think it's a Bloodbraid Elf.
Yeah, it must be, because he wouldn't have given up that win.
That would have been easy.
That would have been one hell of a game.
But two players have to play around that card so that they now get their land instantly destroyed.
Yeah.
Because it must be a total blowout if he had to. Yeah.
Yeah, it's also going to be good against Eldrazi decks, I guess.
Yeah, but not as good.
You're really still pointing at the screen thinking that I think it's a Maelstrom Pulse.
No, I think it's a... It's not a Maelstrom Pulse I'm pointing at. It's a Bloodbraid, I guess.
So Lash continues, and apparently... I didn't see what was the two damage points extra that Michael took. He changed the die to 14. Did you see?
Probably something he revealed.
Other confidant.
Yeah.
Okay, so he flipped another confidant off of the first one.
The
Thoughtseize did 2 damage. Yeah, you're awake. You said you were tired, but you're more awake than me.
Yeah. Still, I think the Azusa is already too long on the board. I want to see it destroyed this turn. And get some pressure going from the gem player. Because, like, the only thing he's doing is, like, drawing removal but not using it. So, yeah, I don't see the point in this.
There isn't a big clock on the table either, so...
Oh, yes, yeah, he can also go for the Bloodbraid, if that's the card I saw.
There it is. It is Assassin's Trophy.
No, it's Bloodbraid.
Really weird art. Confuses me. Is it one of the dual deck arts or something?
I don't know which art it is, but it isn't from the original set. It's from the...
Yeah, that's...
It's from the... What's the name? Eternal Masters? The other art.
Eternal Masters, yeah.
I think it's that art. Yeah, that art it is.
Very confusing. Don't like that. Yeah. So, you had to sack the Azusa, as you already predicted. What did he flip off the top? I guess a land, since he didn't take any damage.
Yeah.
The Blackleaf Cliffs that came into play tap. Yeah. And Lars...
Still doing nothing.
Yeah, he's on 18, but I think he just took 4 damage. He just didn't change the die total, probably.
But, yeah, I don't know what... I draw a Tolaria. I can get a pact. If he wants to. Don't think that will be super bad to get.
He's being very careful, Michael, with the Assassin's... he doesn't have an Assassin's Trophy.
No, but it's I think he should have been playing removal on the Azusa faster.
Yeah.
Because, yeah, Lars now has...
More time.
Mana to work with. And
more mana, more time. He already burned through 2 packs, though. and two Stirring. So
two packs? What? The other pack get Thoughtseize, I guess.
Hmm. Anyway, he's down to two packs now. That's what I meant to say, sorry.
I think Lars still going to have to go for another pact.
Yeah.
Or maybe Walking Ballista. I see him holding that one. But I think the pact Titan play is better. No, don't know for sure.
Well, he did change the die now to 14. So he did take the 4 from the Confident and the Scavenger.
Yeah, because you can unbox.
Yeah. I'm just trying to keep up with what they put on the die total. Because, yeah, that's the most.
Yeah.
They're responsible for the game state. So sometimes players write it down and forget the die. But we will only change it when the die is changed. You see anything else interesting, or are you checking the other deck lists?
I'm checking the other deck lists, and there's also a Jund against UA control, so...
We stay with this combo?
We stay with this side, because
why is that, Tris?
The other Jund player is also not playing Assassin's Trophy.
So we stay with this one, definitely.
Yeah, no new cards, I guess. Checking, but not finding.
Nope.
And the UA control is like, yeah, I don't like the deck because I think it's boring, but I get why people play it, but...
Yeah. Last one for Bojka Bog. And for some reason, he exiled his graveyard.
What? Why?
I don't know.
He picked up because he had creatures in it.
Ah, for the scavenging ghost. That's a smart play. Damn it. Now he played the Snake Shaman. Do you know the name of that creature?
Sakura-type Scout. It can tap to put a land into play. It's a bit...
I always confuse it with the art. It looks a lot like Ancient Stirrings from a distance. It's really weird for me.
No. It doesn't... doesn't look like that. It's like it replacement slowly... of the Summer Bloom. That's why they play the card.
It used to be
Summer of a Bloom Titan.
And now it just focuses on Amulet.
Amulet Titan.
Yeah.
And that's why they play this card.
So at the Michael went down to 13 from a fetch and he up to Sliliana. Both players discarding excess land. It's only lands in Michael's graveyard at the moment. Yeah, another hit for 4.
Yeah. Now it's...
Who's in favor here now that the Maelstrom Pulse will take out the Amulet?
I think...
And a Goyf. I think Jund is definitely... Yeah.
Unless Lars pulls a Titan, then it's all going in Lars's favor. Then.
So it's actually a top deck at the moment. Oh, nice. A Thermo die. That's one of the first. No, I think you brought his own.
Ah.
Thank you, Michael. He has a lot of mana and more land drops to make last, but like you said, the only real
thing. I think Titan is the best draw Lars can have.
He's transmuting Teleria West for a Summoner's Pact again, probably.
I don't know, or maybe as a Ballista. Walking Ballista, so he can take down the Ooze or the Lily,
or even that. That's or gonna that. Be a 3-for-1. That's good. Now who's favorite again, Dries? Liliana active in play.
That was not bad.
Not bad at all.
Yeah, but still, it's a one-off, I guess.
And defensive play, and now another Confident and a Bloodbraid Elf in hand. So that's not going to work.
Bloodbraid.
Oh, that's...
Fail push.
That's pretty good.
Attack for 3, discard. It's going to take damage from a Stomping Ground. Going to 11, each player discarding. Oh, Lars had a Summoner's Pact in hand.
He just drew it?
No, he had it in hand. Why didn't he play it then?
I don't know. He has only one card in hand.
Ah, yeah, but he's discarded the
Sonic. He discarded it?
Yeah.
Ouch, so he now has only one left.
Oh, maybe a Sakamai in his hand. That's the only thing he can't cast at the moment.
What does he have in it?
I think. If he discards the... Oh, but did he have a...
He had lands. He just picked up a bounce land and he played another land. So he only had the Sun Aspect in hand when the Liliana went off.
Yeah, when it...
So he missed his window, actually, to...
But why would you go for the Explosive then if you could go for a Titan?
I don't know.
Isn't Titan...
That's why I was wondering, go for a Titan.
Titan's
another like Liliana, Coif. This is going to be painful.
Yeah.
This is, definitely the jungle. Yeah, Lash is scooping it up. So, we have a win.
Also, that window when Michael had just Assassin's Trophy, just could have won there.
Indeed.
That was nice.
Yeah.
I thought that was nice.
But it's a new card, so maybe the direction hasn't come up yet, so...
I'm eager to see it, so...
Sideboarding, so you have the list for Lars. What do you... board here in this position?
I think you bring in the Ruriktar.
Mm-hmm.
The
Obstinate Bailouts.
Obstinate Bailouts, yeah. Maybe the Spell Pierces, I don't know.
Against Liliana and cascading things.
And the removal. I definitely bring in Ruriktar and maybe the Hornet Queen just to get some big guys going that aren't removed that easily. Ruriktar deals 6 damage if you want to remove it. Sure.
Yeah, sure.
Remove it.
It will do so. No dismember? No? Too much damage? Or a braid?
Maybe a dismember for the Goyf, but I don't think... I think the Goyf can grow bigger than 5-5.
5-6,
it can be a lot bigger than...
6-7? Yeah,
but...
Maybe in combination with a block or something.
I don't know. I don't think the dismember and all is that good to bring in, but I'm not sure.
I'm looking at the Cybert list from Michael the Brabander. He's playing 1 Surgical, 2 Nile Spellbombs, 2 Ancient Grudge. Ancient Grudges are good against the Amulets? Or are they
would
too
you
niche?
Bring in
are they too niche?
I think they're too niche because he's already playing
Collective
Assassin's
Brutality.
It's
good. Collective Brutality 3 off. These are good. You can kill the creatures and get rid of a card.
Yeah, that's good.
That's good. Anger of the Gods.
Nah.
It's too slow. He has better removal, I think.
Yeah.
Tireless Tracker, he don't need it.
Or no.
Does he need
no,
he has enough
need
card
it.
Advantage and Fulminator Mages too.
For the Junt, I would bring in the Surgical.
1 Surgical?
The Collective Brutalities.
All 3?
Maybe
2?
Maybe 2. But also 3 if possible.
Fulminator,
the Fulminator Mages.
2.
But also, if you can, just let them discard and Titan and just Surgical the way, it's, super good.
Yeah, that
because the Titan is, broken in their deck.
Yeah, true. But, if he's bringing in other things that are very...
But the one-offs, you have to just deal with...
Deal with it. And he has enough removal things. The bolts are probably coming out, or did he stay in?
I think the Fatal Push, maybe, and I don't know the bolts. You can shave on the bolts, so I don't know how many cards you want to bring in.
So it was 1-4 with the Brutalities, and 2 more with the Fatal
Push. You shave the bolts, you shave the push.
Liliana the last loop stays in.
Maybe Inquisition, I don't know if Inquisition is good enough, maybe it is. Oh yeah, Liliana the Last Hope, maybe you shave those.
1 Liliana the Last Hope, 3 Liliana the Veil, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, he can.
You can also
cut
the
different 3-4 offs, 1 of each or something.
Cut the Liliana Last Hope and the Inquisitions, the Fatal Push.
So that's 5 cards already.
Yeah,
right,
and
there.
Maybe another card, I don't know, something that doesn't deal damage, so that you can go more aggressive if you want to.
I'm quickly looking through it. Maybe.
Yeah.
One of the.
No, you don't.
Maybe 1 Culligan's
Commander?
Or,
maybe a Liliana of the Veil there, maybe.
Yeah.
But just if you want to go aggressive.
Yeah, so probably...
So you can have the bird to get some reach or...
Yeah.
Because this deck can't gain much life, and if you go with Confident into... another Confident into Goyf, you can go put some pressure.
Or Bloodbraid Elf.
Yeah.
With
blow everything up with
the
ass.
So he did keep the bolts in, of course. He went for a turn 1 Thoughtseize immediately off of Black Leaf Cliffs.
Sorry. Lars is pointing at the opposite ballot, but I don't think Michael is going to take that.
No, I don't think
I hope he's taking the Zakama.
So Zakama, Grove Burrows, two Azusas.
I would take Zakama because it's one of the payoff cards and you don't care about Azusa.
And you can bolt it.
Yeah, because also, yeah, he's selling from that. Those you can keep, but also like the Azusa, he has two lands. If he plays two lands, then why would I don't it's think that's
what? What do you think about Lars Molnar's keep? Is that a hand you should keep?
No, I don't.
I think it's too slow.
I wouldn't keep that hand because also you have two Azusa, but you don't have lands to follow up. So if
indeed
you're just hoping to draw only lands, but
Michael knows he has a ton of time now.
Yeah.
And
Michael took out the Lilianas of the Veil because he know that Lars brings in the
immediately balance. He pulled the Azusa he has left. So that's why he took the first Azusa, because he had an immediate enter for the second one on turn two. And he had his coming to play tap land followed up with a nice confident. He could have played a confident on turn two, but this is just better sequencing and mana efficiency.
What was that? The Braid?
That's Braid.
Yeah, I don't like that.
I didn't see it.
Yeah, it's Cyborg, but I wouldn't Cyborg it, I guess.
I think it's too niche. It has 3 damage, or destroys an artifact.
It's good against the confidence and all, but it wants to go big, I guess, against Chunt.
Yeah, it looks like he kept a slow hand and is going on a mid-range control like.
I don't think don't think you can win that against Chunt. Because Chunt is so much removal and their creatures are much better at controlling than...
A guard advantage through the roof? Yeah. Confident Bloodbraid Elf?
If you have a Titan, then your deck is like...
Insane.
Bonkers going nuts. But yeah, if you don't have the Titan, then it's like me.
Well, the life totals are, I guess, wrong because he just fetched and he put it up to 19 again. But I think he's at 17 because he thought seized.
Yeah, he's at 17. But he gained the life from...
Ah, the Grove.
Yeah. But still, it would be at less.
Yeah, he just... he fetched again.
He fetched twice in the tall season, so he's at...
he should be at
17. Yeah, that is correct.
Let's try.
Oh, maybe... No. He gained 2 life because he only has 1 resource. And so he gained... he played in Azusa, so it's 18. That's correct. We're not paying attention enough.
Yeah, he played Azusa for green and he played in a Braid for red. The other Azusa was thought seized.
Yeah.
So, okay. We're back where we were.
But, I don't know what I have to think about this Titan. I like the deck, but I don't like awesome. How Lars sideboarded it. And, I like the Goivis. Yeah, Lars can't get rid of it. Because it's a 4-5. And if you're board in removal and you're not playing lands or playing big guys, you're not going to win.
That's a lighthouse? That's a lighthouse?
No, it's...
Or the other thing? There's one of those lands that...
That's Slayer's Stronghold.
Slayer Stronghold, okay.
It gives +2/+0 Vigilance Haste, I guess.
Colligan's Command will take care of that immediately. And he took 3 damage from the Bloodbraid Elf and 2 from the Colligan's Command, and he's taking another 8.
But what did the Colligan's Command other mode do?
Destroy the Vigor and 2 damage.
Ah, not discard? Oh no, because he had to ballot. He can't choose
it. Yeah. Mode. He gains another life from the Grove.
Yeah. But I think it's kind of in the bag for Jund. We're just searching for an answer, but I don't know what's in it. Celestia Sanctuary, I guess. I don't know what's it called. Yeah, Sanctuary. Yeah, and he scoops and gives Chant a win because.
So Michael takes down game 2 as well.
Yeah, Michael wins. But yeah, I think Lars did have. I didn't think. It's just that Mulligan, I guess, to take his hand was strong enough to win against the hand of Michael.
Let's quickly check the second table.
Yeah, it's. Our own Jens Jacobs, I guess.
Jens Jacobs on the left.
And I don't know who's on the right. Who's on the right?
You have the list in front of you somewhere.
Jonas Alpers. Don't know him, I guess.
He plays a lot here, though.
Yeah, it's a familiar face, but...
Jonas is also playing.
Doesn't ring a bell.
We have no clue what the match score is over there. But
I'm saying 1-1.
What's Jens playing?
Jens is playing UA Control. And Jonas is playing Junt.
That's a classic matchup.
Yeah, still rooting for Junt on this one.
Because you really don't like...
I don't want to hate on Jens, but yeah, I don't like the deck he's playing. I hope he wins, but yeah. I think if you have a struggling hand, then Junt has the disruption and you have all the planeswalkers against your deck.
Indeed. Apparently, there is a total of 46 people for the modern event, and the vintage that simultaneously is going on have 16 players.
Oh,
that's nice. Very nice. Kitchen Finks.
From the gen player. And says an ancestral vision suspended. Can you adjust the life totals?